We all consume honey one way or another. Sometimes we use honey to make our drinks taste better. Other times we use it to make sweets and food. Although everyone have used honey at least once in their life, no one really seems to know about it. All I knew about honey before making this documentary was honey tastes sweet and it is produced by monstrous creatures, bees.
Every time we go honey shopping, the most difficult decision we make is about the shape of the jar. Here in the United States, there are more than enough varieties and brands of honey that we could purchase. So I decided to go to my local grocery store and purchase the best and highest quality honey available. Once I got there, sure, there was more varieties than I needed, but I just couldn't decide and choose which one is the best one. Every bottle had one thing in common. The label. On all and each bottle, there was a label which said pure natural honey. I found that hard to believe. I had no idea how difficult and stressful purchasing honey could get. Knowing the fact that I still wasn't able to enjoy my breakfast without having the best quality honey kept me up and sleepless at night. So I decided to end it all at once by researching and looking for an answer online. After hours of researching, I came across a documentary on Netflix about the reality of honey production in the United States.
It's straight out of the drug dealer playbook. Cut your pure product with inexpensive filler to increase volume.
Ten or 20 years ago, syrups that came from corn or from sugar cane were mostly used to adulterate honey. Around 25 years ago in the United States, a method was developed to detect that type of adulteration. And then the Chinese discovered some years ago that syrups manufactured from rice are not detected by this method. In some way, there seems to be a surplus of honey. And where does that honey come from? If we consider that the production is decreasing and the demand is increasing, the only way to explain that gap is honey adulteration.
It's a simple but ugly truth. Lots of the honey flowing around the world isn't pure honey.
The dilution of honey with cheap syrups is the main and more massive way to adulterate honey. It is the reason of this apparent surplus of honey all over the world.
Here to try to purchase the best quality honey that we could, but it's kind of impossible because just by looking at the labels and just by looking at what they have, we don't really know what's going on in it, and we don't want to get something that's fake or something that's just honey, so we can't really choose from here. The only solution that comes to my mind is to find a local farmer and try to get some advice from them. It's been a couple of years that I wake up every day, make myself coffee, pour some honey into it, and I just enjoy that. But recently, I've been thinking about, is it really honey that I'm putting into my coffee? Or is it just something that looks like honey? Whatever it is, it makes my coffee taste really good. But I like a coffee that tastes much better. So I'm going to New York upstate today. I'm meeting a local
bee farmer. He invited me to check out his farm, and they're trying to prepare for winter, and they're sealing the beehives, or making sure that the beehives are sealed and ready for winter. So let's check it out. So here we are at the bee farm, and it looks gorgeous. This is in upstate New York, in Hopeville Junction.
After driving north about an hour, I finally arrived at my destination. I was truly mesmerized. I was welcomed by the true and untouched beauty of the nature. Yes, I know if you truly love nature, you will find beauty everywhere. But this place was far more beautiful than what I expected it to be.
This is Farhad, a local honey farmer who started farming honey for the same reason that brought me all the way up to upstate New York today: search of real honey. Hi, Farhad.
Hey, what's up?
So why don't you tell us what you're doing right now?
Actually, it's the winter time coming, so I'm coming here because I wanna cover the colony for winter time.
So you're basically preparing the hives for winter time and cold times.
Exactly.
So yeah. What happens if you don't and just leave them like that?
So sometimes it's getting so cold and they cannot keep the queen warm, and they're gonna die. So I'm trying to keep them of the
cold weather
and freezing time. So I cover them by plastic wrap and some insulation for the winter time.
Yeah. That's great. So let me ask you another question. Why did you start keeping bees, and how long you've been doing it?
Actually, I was looking for 100% organic honey for my wife, but I couldn't find it anywhere. So I tried to start it by myself, and I learned how to keep them and how to raise them.
That's great. Yeah,
and it's more than 8 years.
Wow, so you've been doing it for 8 years?
Yeah, absolutely.
Is there any specific reason that you chose your beehives to be up here by Hopeville Junction and by all these trees and grape trees?
Yes, because the environment here is so nice. We have a lot of different flowers in different seasons, and actually we have some orchard here. We have a lot of kind of fruits like apples, cherries, and some peach, and they're gonna give us a lot of juice and pollen. So we need the honey and pollen for that colonies and the hive.
So what I'm hearing is that it's really important what the bees are feeding themselves, right?
What is that?
So it's very important for the bees to feed on specific food.
Yeah, because you need them, otherwise you have to feed them by some stuff like sugar or stuff like that. I don't want to do that. I need 100% organic feeding.
So have you seen anybody that cheats the process, or other farmers that try to accelerate the process?
Actually, I want to tell you, 75%, maybe 80% of the honey sellers, they cheating on the honey because they have to feed them sugar to get more honey. But I don't want to sell it. I want it for my family. So that's good for me to keep them 100% organic. So I'm not feeding nothing. But the bad part is, sugar is the good things that if somebody give them. Sometimes they give them some stuff worse than sugar. Like, I don't know what is that. So That's not healthy. That's not real honey.
One more question and the last one. Have you actually been stung by bees, or have you been attacked by bees before?
it's a normal happen every time happened to me. Even I have my gloves. I have 2-3 layers of clothes. Yeah, they sting me, but it's good. It's good. It's keep your ammunition powerful.
All right, thank you, Farhad.
All right.
The farmer was nice enough to let me help with the process of sealing the hives.
even though it was a new feeling and experience to work that close to a functioning beehive, but I still wasn't sure enough if local farm honey was pure or not. So to make my head clear, I had to ask him one last question. By the way, that's how the hives look like after sealing them. So now we're done with wrapping the hives, I have one more essential question.
Yes, sir.
How many pounds does one colony of bees usually produce without giving them extra food or sugar? Basically natural honey.
It depends on environment, the flowers, the orchard. But normally a hive like this.
The second one? The first three to the left. The first
three give you something between 15 to 20 pounds. And this one, these three with two levels, give you between 30 to 45 pounds per year.
And that's per year?
Yeah, one time.
And how long is the season usually?
It started sometimes April or March, and it's going to finish around November. It depends on seasons and the year.
At this point, we definitely can draw a conclusion and say 99% of the honey out there isn't pure honey. But before we do that, let's take a look at the documentary Rotten one more time.
A worker bee lives about 40 days and makes less than a teaspoon of honey. But in high season, the 50,000 bees in a single colony can make 30 pounds a week.
That's at least 60 pounds. We're gonna give it a couple bounces.
Unfortunately, even local farmers feed their bees and try to cheat the process. As we saw in the documentary Rotten, the farmer that was being interviewed was telling us that he produces up to 60 pounds a week naturally. As where we heard from Farhad, the local farmer that I interviewed, you only could get up to 45 to 50 pounds per year if you farm honey totally naturally. The cheating process is pretty simple. All the farmer has to do is saturate water with as much as sugar that he can and feed the bees that saturated solution. Basically, they place cups of that solution in the hives so the bees don't have to travel outside and they could feed themselves as much as they want inside the hive. But the honey that gets produced from that solution is simply sugar and it doesn't have any of the good benefits of real honey. By making this documentary, I learned two simple lessons. First, 99% of the honey out there isn't real honey. Unfortunately, most of us won't ever get to taste real honey even once in our lifetimes. Simply, every time we go honey shopping and we pay for honey, we are getting a scam. Second, bees aren't monstrous creatures at all. Even though their brain is as big as a sesame seed, they have a really good talent of learning and memorizing this stuff. They always work in groups and they communicate all the time. Also, they only have one goal as a community, protecting their queen. So next time you see a bee flies into your room, do me a favor. Just open the window and let it fly away instead of killing it.